Hi there, I'm Alex Berg, and I'm joined by...
Helge.
And we're playing...
What are you playing?
Playing Divinity.
Divinity! Yep.
The fast-paced action game where we got our asses handed to us by some sort of skeletal thingamabobber.
Yeah, the first fight wasn't that bad. I think basically we're gonna have to get some more crew members.
Yeah, why don't we just skip this and go back and find... the bloody tavern.
I mean, how hard could it be?
Yeah, seriously. Where, if you were a tavern...
Ooh, another grave I can dig up. Yep, that sounds reasonable.
Okay, so they actually bothered to mark... Are you still doing that?
Oh, I found another monster.
Yes, I see.
I'm afraid it's Helm.
Say what?
Undead Helm, though.
Okay.
Well, it's your turn.
Yes, I need 6 action points, so... I can move 1 step.
Probably shouldn't be doing all this grave robbing, should I?
Wow.
Well, you know, I found the shovel. What are you gonna do?
Yeah.
And Hell is on fire.
Are you referring to him as Hell? Oh no, Hell.
Helen?
Oh. It's a woman.
It's a woman's. Blodge.
Oh, that was... Wow.
300 experience points for Helen.
Congratulations, Helen.
You thought... Helen, killed by an enraged zombie. I'm sure we can talk this out. Right, you found the shovel too. Good, good.
Yes, we have
good,
shovels.
Then the, yes. Yes, the big shovel story. Do these mouths grow back?
God.
Oh, look at this guy. Look at this. What the hell?
That looks like a bird.
That looks like a bird. What the? Alright, Jared. This is good, this is good.
I feel very much I shouldn't be standing next to that guy.
I don't know. Wow! Wow! Wow!
Yeah. Hi there.
Hello. I just returned from the after. Alright, no more digging of the graves.
Here lies Jared. Shall I come back as an enraged spirit or as a lovable prankster ghost?
I think he came back as an enraged spirit.
A prankster spirit, something like that? I don't know. Alright, look. Surely, where's a bloody tavern?
I'm pretty sure we passed it on the way in here.
Yeah.
It's probably one of those houses that are just... in the fog of war. So let's just go find that.
Well, I think I found it.
You think you found it?
So it looks like a tavern.
It does kind of look like a tavern, doesn't it?
It looks like a tavern to me. I mean, I haven't been in many taverns. Greetings. There's a bar and...
You there! A moment of indulgence, if you please. You are the source hunter, are you not? The hero of the whole of Sicil is a Oh my god, I'm so drunk now I can't even read. The hero of the whole of Sicil is a buzz about. A buzz about? The talk of the town, the juiciest grape on the grapevine. Such a pleasure to meet you. A delight. No, scratch that. It's so much more than a delight. It's an intervention of fate. Yes, that's it. Fate has put me on this very spot so that I may tell you about a most intriguing opportunity indeed.
That sounds like a scam, doesn't it?
Yeah, it does.
But let's fall for it.
Yes, let's. Oh, it's not merely an opportunity. It's a once-in-a-lifetime chance to become... Better. To become the full extent of the promise that is locked inside each and every one of us. So, first of all, let me ask you a question. Do you like adventure? Now, the answer, the alternatives are, of course I do. How could someone in my profession not? And I'm here to do my duty, which is hard
just
with the
same stuff. Just go for the one you think is fine. We'll
Oh, of course I do. Oh, you have to say something too.
Yep. Adventure is what we live for.
So there. You and I share the same passion. I never doubted it for a moment. The thrill of walking the unbeaten path, the rush of finding yourself in a goblin ambush, knowing you'll prevail nonetheless. Too bad your line of work comes with such a measly recompense. Am I right? The wage of a mere soldier. Now, between you and me, it's supposed to be you and I, isn't it? Tell me truthfully, don't you sometimes wish you would earn more? Well, I can't say that I haven't, and riches do not interest me, actually.
Yeah, it's a dual conversation as well.
We're so altruists, aren't we? So we're doing riches don't interest me, actually.
Nor me. Wealth is but vanity.
Oh, but you know... But I know you're just being bashful. I bet in your heart of hearts your eyes water with the joy when you discover yet another treasure during your travels.
Well, that's probably true.
Even so, my friend, matters of pecuniary nature aside, what is life without variety? Without spice, to be a source hunter must get frightfully jerry sometimes, am I right? All those orders, investigate this, retrieve that, and at the end of the day, what do you have to show for it? Wouldn't you prefer to call your own shots and be your own boss? It's better to lead than to follow, that much is true. There is no shame in following directives if your masters are worthy of your trust. And we're the goody ones, so...
There we go.
Come now, I refuse to believe such a uniquely skilled individual would settle for a puppet's role. Life's too short to spend it doing someone else's bidding, am I right? Of course I am, and I could help you attain the dream, enact the change you deserve. I like the way we're just leading him on by going, no, it's fine, no.
Yeah, we don't do that sort of stuff.
And that's exactly why I'm here, why fate has put me right at the door of the King Crab. Ah, we're at the right place. So,
finally, good.
So that I could meet you and tell you about the marvel that is the Fabulous Five. The invitation to join is yours. Grab it.
What's that, man?
Okay, we have UR. Tell me more about the Fabulous Five. I'm not worried about the undead. And you are? Manteus, at your service. What's my profession? Well, I'll tell you what it used to be. And that is a man of medicine. Oh, good. We could use a healer. But what does a man of medicine do but to mend what has first been broken? I saved lives, to be sure, but today I changed them. Tell me more about the Fabulous Five. Ah, the Fabulous Five. How I enjoy simply saying the words that describe the most illustrious and celebrated adventurers' guild in Rivellum. Our mission, to better the world. Our mantra, to better ourselves as we do so. To realize our dreams and to cleanse our souls. You'd like nothing more than to enlist, wouldn't you? Of course you do. And you can, of course. If you still have questions, I shall answer them to the best of my abilities. But if not, how about we get started? So what do they actually
do? I think we have to join, don't you?
Let's ask what they actually do. What a gem of a question. Straight as an arrow, sharp as a switchblade. Most good of you. Now then, to join the Fabulous Five is to join a fellowship, to join a fraternity, a sorority, a community. The title of knight is bestowed upon you the moment you signed our waiver, and so it all begins. I shall be the one to give you your first contracts, and once the job is done, I shall see to it that you get your fair share of the reward. So I follow his orders then. Of course, should you spread the word, should you propagate the gospel of the Fabulous Five and thereby draw new knights to our fellowship, this is a pyramid scheme. You will get a share of the reward from the contracts too. Isn't that wonderful? This is basically multi-level marketing. This is the exact pitch of a multi-level marketer.
Yep. I don't see a problem with that.
By now, the genial glow of the fellowship must be worn... must have warmed your heart. It has, hasn't it? But did I say fellowship? I mean family. For like a family, we support one another, cheer one another, see one another through thick and thin, partake in glory and defeat. Work hard, fulfill contracts, enlist new knights, and swiftly shall you rise through the ranks. Will you better yourself? Will you better Revlon? Will you make the stars shine all the brighter? Will you get fabulously wealthy in the process? What's not to like? I'd like to enlist or change the subject.
Yeah, let's enlist.
Of course, of course. All you need to do is sign the waiver, and just like that, snap, you're part of the family. All needs is your lovely little autograph. What do you say? Join the guild, better the world, earn lots of gold. Yes, count me in. This Fabulous Five business sounds too good to be true. I'm going to pass. I say it sounds too good to be true.
Yeah, but it's fun.
I don't believe this for a second. I don't think this is a gateway to quests.
Alright, just do what you feel is right.
I think it's a trap. Somehow. Fabulous Five sounds too good to be true. I'm gonna pass. Okay, what do you say? Rather foolish to pass up such a lucrative opportunity, don't you think? I'm not going to join some freak show, and neither are you. Okay. I'm gonna try to get you out of a bad deal, don't you see? Are you telling me this is not the most double-faced guy you ever met? Alright, we'll do it your way. Are you gonna be an idiot, or are you gonna be reasonable?
Alright. Look, I mean, one of the options I have is, listen! We're the Terrific Two will soon become a one-man act if you don't join the Fabulous Five.
That's a pretty good retort.
That's pretty good, but I'll go with something calmly then.
Oh! Win a series of rock, paper, scissors matches to convince the other party. Put points in charisma to gain an advantage.
Yep. Ah!
Okay, so you won that round?
Yeah, you see I got 3 dots.
Yeah. And then I get 3 dots?
Yep.
Okay.
Then we get no dots. Now, look at that. Aha!
Clever lad.
Look at me go.
You actually
deal.
Want us to join that thing?
It'll be fun.
I'm not entirely convinced it will be.
Are you really sure?
Yes, I'm really sure.
Yeah, fuck. Well, we're joining it.
Fuck me running. Marvelous, magnificent. Oh, but what am I saying? Fabulous is the word. You may not realize it yet, but your fortunes, your very life is about to change for the better. So let us not dilly-dally. To business. Your first assignment is ready and waiting if you're ready and willing.
Of course.
It's a pretty straightforward task, this one. Now, in this town dwells a wizard. Aru is his name, and he is a frightful eccentric. Scientific type, you know the kind. Favors reason over faith and all that. Not Fabulous Five material, him. His experimental weapons may keep a couple of skeletons away from the city, but many of his other researches failed, malfunctions with tragic consequences. One of them was a big lumbering apparatus, a frightful automaton, thank you. Shaped like a giant made of steel. It was supposed to crush the undead by the dozens, piloted as it was by a trained legionnaire. But you can guess what happened. Did it become sentient? Was it cursed? Whatever the cause, the thing relieved itself of its pilot and headed north towards a network of caves. Now ask yourself, what if it comes back? It could smash the city walls and claim hundreds of lives before being subdued. Luckily, there are those in this world who belong to the Fabulous Five, the braves who eat such monstrosities for breakfast. Go, my friend, find this wizard's abomination and claim your just reward from Mayor Cecil in the name of the of our hallowed guild. Easy money!
See? This sounds like a great idea.
Yeah.
You see that? You're always thinking you're the smart one, but you're not. You see, I'm the smart one. Look, there's a cat you can talk to. Crazy old cook.
Greetings!
Meow! Never saw you in the King's Crab before. You're welcome to scratch me behind the ears if you like. I won't scratch back.
Who are you?
I am Unsinkable Sam. At least that's what they call me around here. Used to be a ship's cat, but the clipper I was on sank, and I was the only one to wrestle himself free of the waves. The people here have been kind and took me in. Been the King's Crab's foremost patron ever since. Tell me more about the ship you're on. A magnificent ship it was. Used to belong to a pirate, I was told. Unlike me, she didn't prove to be unsinkable, though. We hit the cliffs right beneath the lighthouse. Not very apt name for that building, I must say, for no light was shining from it. The moment I hit the water, I whirled around like I would on a hot tin roof. By some miracle, I managed to reach the beach, covered in kelp and smelling worse than a fish's funeral parlor. But I was alive, and that's more than anybody else could say. You were the only survivor? So I was. What friends I had, they drowned alongside the rats I used to hunt in the galley, and there I was, all alone. Not that I have had it bad here, mind you. I've milk and fish aplenty, most folk will pet me kindly, and when one of the village girls holds me tight against her ample bosom, I purr up a storm. But I do long for the companion of my own kind. For a companion of my own kind, and in that regard, there is no one like Maxine. About Maxine. Maxine, the mayor's darling pet, so gentle, so fair, feline. The grace of her whiskers, the subtle palette of dyes in her sable coat. She's one of a kind, that cat. She likes me, I know she does. But when I declare my love, she backs away. I don't know why. I've serenaded her and braved many a bucket of water for my effort. But for some reason, it is not. She is not to be swayed. I have some questions for you, by all means. What's your take on the undead?
We got stuff to do.
I'm talking to the cats.
Yeah, you won't join the Fabulous Five and get some real missions going, but no, let's talk to the cat. Clearly the cat's a witch. Only one surviving. It's terrible.
It's Unsinkable Sam. Don't diss Unsinkable Sam. He's cool.
I'm dissing Unsinkable Sam right in front of you. What's he gonna do?
I'll leave the Fabulous Five, that's what I'm gonna do. People make a fuss about them because they endanger the lands around the city. They never bother me when I'm out for a monthly walk, though. But still, I do detest them. I mean, they're so unnatural, aren't they? Cats have 9 lives, but humans are only entitled to 1. Can you tell me more about the orcs? Oh, don't mention the orcs to me. Worse than the dogs, the lot. Sank Walrus's willy boat right from under him. Best anchovy fisher in the world where I was. Lost us all.
Bye.
Take my leave. Okay, so we now have a quest to find a mate for the cat. Believe it or not.
Great.
Yeah, that is awesome, isn't it? So
where's
who
are
this?
We actually talking to? Yeah.
Well, they're supposed to, I'm pretty sure it's upstairs. It's probably where the scene of the crime or something.
Alright, let's go upstairs and have a look. Nope, it's down here.
Oh, okay. Stop right there! Till I receive the captain's permission, something, something, something.
Okay. We spoke to your warriors. Let me inside, please. Not exactly the friendliest bloke, the captain, is he? Well, the reward is getting your hair chewed off and balls to the finest magical murder scene. Enjoy! So off we are to waltz into the world's finest magical murder scene.
World's finest magical murder scene. Whoa!
Well, bang!
Okay.
They're right. Okay.
Yeah.
Well, that happened.
So, yeah.
I'm Lady Godiva.
Well, hello there.
Look at this fucker.
Zigzags. Yep. By the quill. Is that quill 18? By the quill, that lasts a billion words. What's this? What are you doing here? Where the seven stars come to die? Who are you and where have you come from? Source answer from the realm of Rillum. Who am I? Who the devil are you? No. We may find ourselves at the terminus of time, but I asked you first, and it's only courteous to provide an imp of good and honest standing with the answer he desires. Upon reflection, though, it hardly matters who you are, for the question is who, but how. All we did was approach a strange stone, it shone in the blinding light and then whirled us away. A stone, you say? Could be. Could I have been right all along? This stone, what was it? Was it bright and beauteous as a diamond? But did it glow softly deep down in its heart?
Yes, that's obviously it's a stone.
That's a fairly accurate description. Star stone! Must be. For centuries it slept, this bounty of heavens, but now it's waking and it has brought its awakeners here. All was dark and all was still, and it always has been, always could. Blah, 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 blah. Ferrisome, yes. Yes, plot
100. I think that imp quite mad. Then we'd better appease him and have a look through the looking lens.
I think we must loot. I will have a sit and you can go loot.
There's some bottle of beers and wine, that's just about it.
Well, that's not all. Wait, the only just.
It's a nice place, though. I like the look of it. Look at that.
There's pillows and everything.
Really?
Empty darn bottles. Oh! Well.
Well. Who's the guy sleeping on the...
Who do you think it is?
What? It's you, isn't it? You having a kip?
A bit of a kip? Whoa!
What the hell is going on there?
I'm looking through the looking glass thing. Are you seeing this?
No, I'm not seeing it.
Okay, touch the looking glass.
Oh, yeah, look. Oh, look at that! That's quite nice, that is.
What strange new world is
right, apparently we are... At you.
Where on the world what? Am I?
I touched the glowing thing.
Alright, I'm coming.
Oh, there you are.
There we are.
Okay, so we're somewhere else. That old thing about getting some companions and stuff, that sort of flew out the window, didn't it?
Yeah, let's...
Yeah, whatever.
I'm sure we'll get there. We'll get there. There's a locked chest, can we... Oh my god, it's a speaking chest. He wants us to find his four sisters.
Will you not speak, milady?
Right.
I long for your stories and your...
Okay.
Zigzag! I've tried every imaginary tongue, from dwarfin to lizardese. But this woman simply won't budge. Maybe she doesn't like the look of a refined, impish face of mine. Perhaps you have better luck. But do not report back what he finds, or Sontron. Do please report back. I can't read either.
Oh my god. Yeah, blah blah blah. Create time, blah blah blah. No longer did I weave, so there, blah blah blah. Backstory, blah 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 blah. So new threads emerge. I began to weave anew. Yada yada yada, tapestry of time. So many questions. Oh my god, no, I'll take
the
my
plot name. Thickens. We should tell the imp the weaver's tale.
Oh my god. Okay.
Well, hello there.
The dark does not scare me.
bleak prospect indeed, blah blah blah. She talked to me. There you go. Okay, the imp historian, he's tasked by the gods to write the history of all creation. That's, so he's not exactly a nobody.
Nice.
Okay, right. Portal flanks looking lands, but still was inert. The runestones adorn the spirit. Blah, blah. Oh my god, so many things.
Well, it is an RPG.
Yes.
There is a lot of.
You received a runestone that allows you to quick travel. Use the homestead travel button on the right side of the screen under the minimap.
Rift travel. Oh, look at that.
Where is it?
Alright, you see the little diamond triangle?
Yeah, got it. Okay.
Well, that's a happy.
North gate?
There's a lot of portals here.
Really? I only have.
Yeah, but they're all inactive. No, I'm looking around in the place.
Oh, yeah. Okay. So this is a sort of Nexus hub thing. Yeah, inactive portal. Yeah, I see it.
Yeah, there's a lot of. There's a.
Well, I'm pretty sure whoever guessed magic as the cause of death are probably onto something.
I would say so. So, what's our question? We're gonna go home.
We can probably come back here later, can't we?
Well, as much as we'd like, I think.
This is the end of time, so yeah. Northgate.
All right.
You must gather your party before venturing forth. Oh my god! I can't believe they did that one. Saying from the Sword Coast, often repeated.
Oh yeah, definitely.
Most deaf.
Most deaf.
Okay, so we're back. Yeah, I suggest we find a bench and have a bit of a sit down.
Beyond these walls.
All right. Now I can't see one.
Nope, we also need to get back to the inn, don't we?
Yep, I think so.
Where was the inn? It's not marked on the map, is it?
Of course it is.
It's not on
is
my
it?
Map.
Nope, no it isn't.
But it's right below us here, right? You're
just
on the
follow
way to...
me. It's a really big one in the middle of the map.
Yeah. Wow. You say middle of the map, but...
Just follow me.
Oh, come on. Move your feet. God damn it. Not in the mood for cheese? Who's not in the mood for cheese? Everybody's in the mood for cheese. Okay.
I'm always in the mood for cheese.
Come, have a seat. So, while you're sort of inside the table, I think we'll call quits for tonight. So, thanks for watching, guys. I've been Iceberg, and you've been...
Helge.
And cheers.
And have fun.